हॅलो एव्हरीवन, माय सेल्फ लेक्चरर अदिती अनिल कुशारे, मास्टर ऑफ फार्मसी इन क्वालिटी अश्युरन्स टेक्निक्स. नाऊ वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द फार्मास्युटिक्स टू एक्सपेरिमेंट्स. इन दॅट वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट इमल्शन, इंट्रोडक्शन टू बायफेजिक लिक्विड डोसेज फॉर्म्स इमल्शन. अँड इमल्शन इज अ हेट्रोजिनस सिस्टीम कन्सिस्टिंग ऑफ ॲटलीस्ट वन एमिसिबल लिक्विड dispersed in the form of droplets diameter that is 0.1 micrometer to 100 micrometer is called dispersed phase, and the liquid in which the globules are dispersed is called continuous phase. The two immiscible liquids cannot be dispersed for long period, so an emulsifying agent having the peculiar structure in which one end is hydrophilic and other is lipophilic is used. Because of that, it is possible for emulsifying agent to form a thin film at the interface and reduce the interfacial tension. So let's see about the classification of emulsion. That is, the simple classification is oil in water, O by W type, and water in oil means W by O type. In this oil in water, O by W type, we have oil is an internal phase while water acts as an external phase. While in this water in oil type, W means water, which is an internal phase, while oil is an external phase. There are the tests to decide the type of emulsion. There are total four tests, that is the dye test, dilution test, conductivity test, and fluorescence test. So the emulsifying agents can be divided as follows. The emulsifying agents are natural, semi-synthetic, synthetic, inorganic, and alcohols. So in natural, there are two types, vegetable source and animal source. In vegetable, we have gum acacia, tragacanth, agar, pectin, starch, then ureomos, that is chondrus. And animal source means wool fat, egg yolk, gelatin. Semi-synthetic, methyl cellulose, sodium carboxymethyl cellulose, that is sodium CMC. Synthetic, anionic, cationic, non-ionic, which containing charges. Anionic means containing negative charge, cationic positive charge, non-ionic that are chargeless. Inorganic, milk of magnesia, magnesium oxide, magnesium trisilicate, magnesium aluminium silicate, and bentonite. And the alcohols, that is carbovaxes, cholesterol, lecithins. Then emulsions for oral mixture are made with naturally occurring gums, as they are inert with the respective therapeutic agent. Acacia is the best emulsifying agent for extemporaneous preparation for oral emulsion, and are the stable over a wide range of pH, that is 2 to 10, but they are too sticky for external use. The tragacanth increases the viscosity, however, it is not good emulsifying agent. The monovalent soaps which form O by W, that is oil in water type of emulsion, means in which oil is an internal phase while water acts as an external phase. This O by W type of emulsion are not useful for oral mixture as they cause hemolysis. Preparation of emulsions. The following methods are commonly used for the preparation of emulsions on a small scale, that is dry gum method, wet gum method, bottle method, and other methods. First of all, let's discuss about dry gum method. In this, first of all, we have to measure the required quantity of oil in a dry measure and transfer it into a dry mortar. Then add the calculated quantity of gum acacia into it and triturate so as to form a uniform mixture. Then third one, add required quantity of water and triturate vigorously till a clicking sound is produced and the product becomes white or nearly white due to the total internal reflection of light. The emulsion produced at this stage is known as primary emulsion. Then fourth one, add more of water with the trituration to produce the required volume. Then the following table shows the proportion of oil, water, and gum acacia required for different types of oils. Serial number, type of the oil, example, ratio of oil as to water as to gum. So first of all, fixed oil, example, castor oil, almond oil, arachis oil, cod liver oil, the ratio of oil as to water as to gum is 4 as to 2 as to 1. Second, volatile oil, that are turpentine oil, peppermint oil, and cinnamon oil, ratio of oil as to water as to gum is 2:2:1. Third one, mineral oil, liquid paraffin, ratio of oil as to water as to gum is 3:2:1. Then wet gum method, second method of preparation of emulsion is wet gum method. In this method, the proportion of oil as to water as to gum for preparing the primary emulsion is the same as given in the table. Calculate the quantity of oil, water and gum required for preparing the primary emulsion. Then powder the gum acacia in a mortar, add water and triturate it with gum as to form mucilage. Then third one, add the required quantity of oil in the small portion with the rapid trituration until a clicking sound is produced, and the produce, it will becomes white or nearly white. At this stage, the emulsion is known as primary emulsion. Then fourth one, add more of water in small portion to the primary emulsion with the trituration to produce the required volume of uniform emulsion. And fifth one, transfer the emulsion to a bottle, cork it, label and submit. Then third one, bottle method. Bottle method is used for the preparation of emulsions of volatile and other non-viscous oils. This proportion of oil as to water as to gum is 2:2:1. Measure the required quantity of the oil and the transfer into a large bottle. Add required quantity of powdered gum acacia. Then second one, shake the bottle vigorously until the oil and gum are mixed thoroughly. Third one, add the calculated amount of water all at once. Then fourth one, shake the mixture vigorously to form a primary emulsion. Fifth one, add more of water in a small portions with the constant agitation to produce the required volume. Then recommended container, screw capped plain bottles. Special labeling instructions are shake well before use as it is a liquid dosage form. Then enemas, these are the solutions, suspensions or oil in water emulsions of medicaments intended for rectal administration. Container is a single-use plastic pack with the rectal nozzle. So in next session, we will see about the experiments. Experiment number 42. Title of this experiment is to prepare and submit the emulsion, that is lime cream type, 10 ml. This is the biphasic liquid dosage forms for external use. Proposition 1 is W by O, that is water in oil. Water is internal phase and oil acts as external phase. W by O, emulsions of fixed oils in which calcium soap is the emulsifying agent are termed as the lime creams. And proposition 2, some oils like olive oil contain sufficient free acid to form the enough soap with the lime water to emulsify the rest of the oil. Learning objectives are to understand the use of calcium soap in preparation of emulsion for external use and the ability to prepare a stable WYO water in oil, that is water is the internal phase, oil acts as the external phase, WYO emulsion by following the method correctly. Apparatus required are mortar, pestle, glass rod, beaker. Factor calculated as the quantity required upon quantity given, that is equal to 10 upon 15 is equal to 0.66. This is the prescription, which is denoted by the symbol Rx. Calamine 1 gram, zinc oxide 1 gram, olive oil, that is a quantity sufficient, and the liquid calcium hydroxide, that is calcium hydroxide solution 15 ml. So this is the formula table. Type means the category, use or the role of ingredient, translation, name of ingredient, quantity given in imperial system is not given. We have the directly formula in the metric system. So quantity given in metric system for preparing 15 ml and quantity taken in metric system to prepare up to 10 ml. So first of all, calamine, which is used as pain and itching reliever. The quantity given in the metric system is 1 gram. With the help of factor, we can calculate the quantity for the taken to prepare up to 10 ml, that is 0.66 gram. Second, zinc oxide, used as astringent, protective and antiseptic. Quantity given in metric system is 1 gram. So quantity required to prepare 10 ml, that is 0.66 gram. Skin, moisture and cleanser, that is olive oil. Quantity given in the metric system is a quantity sufficient, and the quantity taken in metric system is also the quantity sufficient to weight this calamine and zinc oxide. Calcium hydroxide solution used as a vehicle, quantity given in the metric system is a 15 ml and quantity taken in metric system, that is quantity sufficient to prepare up to 10 ml. Direction to be used as directed by physician.
So now for performing of actual experiment, we will shift to the lab for performing experiment. So we have, this is calamine, which is a previously weighed. This is a zinc oxide, which is also previously weighed. This is the olive oil, which is taken into this beaker. And this is calcium hydroxide, from which we have already prepared this calcium hydroxide solution. I am going to add this zinc oxide and then calamine into this mortar. And then after that, I am also going to add this olive oil into it. And then we will proceed for trituration. Then after that, I am going to add this calcium hydroxide solution into it. Then again we will triturate it properly. Then after that, I am pour that particular solution from mortar pestle to this measuring cylinder and proceed for only makeup part with the help of that calcium hydroxide solution. And after making the volume, now I am going to transfer it into this container and then we will proceed for next labeling part. So now move towards labeling part. So the labeling of formulation, emulsion 10 ml for ABC, that is name of patient, register number XYZ, that is number given in the register, dispensed by PQR, means name of pharmacist, date, manufacturing date September 2020. Storage condition, store in cool and dark place. One more another direction, shake well before use and use as directed by physician. Manufactured by Element Pharmacy, Nasik. Result, the 10 ml of this emulsion is submitted in this amber colored glass bottle for the inspection of special inspection written as shake well before.